right? As we all know, we're here today in the sight of God, in the sight of witnesses, in the sight of family, to see this union, this joining together of Heath and Lauren for the purposes of getting married. Now we know that God is the creator and designer of all marriage. It was God's design that a man should be with a woman, and a woman should be with a man. God ordained it and designed it. His Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, also came to fulfill that same wedding and that bond that we witness today. The Apostle Paul even writes about it in the book of 1 Corinthians. And he reads and he says this: "And now I will show you the most excellent way. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angry. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always preserves. There are three pillars on which a marriage may be built: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love." And that's what we're here to witness today. Who gives this woman to be married today? Let's pray. Father, we ask that you just be with us now. Father, we ask as you have ordained this marriage, that from the very beginning of creation, Father, you designed and created man to be with woman, and woman to be with man, that neither one of them should not be alone, but be together. Father, we pray that you'll be with us today. Be with this ceremony. Father, would you be with this couple? Would you embrace them and keep them? And we praise you and we lift you on high. Of course, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As a pastor, part of my job is to give you my charge. It's based on the gospel. It's based on God's charge of what the wedding and the ceremony is supposed to be like. This, in a way, is my charge and my vow to you that we'll exchange together. When we get through, y'all will exchange the vows that you have written toward one another in like fashion. So, Heath, we'll start with you. As we go through this charge, we have to remember God is the center of this marriage. Always has been and always will be. So not only the vows that you say to one another today are for you, but we're acknowledging that God is ever more present in your life today. And without him, the marriage cannot be possible. Heath, do you take Lauren to be your wedded wife? Do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love her, that you will comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for her alone, you will perform unto her all the duties that a husband owes to his wife until God, by death, shall separate you? Lauren, do you take me to be your wedded husband? And you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love him, that you'll comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and that forsaking all others for him alone, you will perform unto him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband until God by death shall separate you?
I love you. Very simple, very good. You're the epitome of
all know the ring is symbolic of many things. And we've heard the story of the ring many times. That the ring is a solid circle. If you'll notice, it doesn't have a beginning. It doesn't have an end. Now, a marriage has a beginning. But if it's ordained by God, it is to be eternal. It is to last forever. And like the ring, if you go round and round, you'll not find an ending point. Your marriage is to be like that. The more you go round and round, realize it's never over. It never ends. It only gets better. Heath, what token do you have today as an appreciation for your love? Would you place it on the table and repeat after me? With this ring, I thee wed. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lauren, in like fashion, what token do you have to show your desire, your love, and your affection for me? Would you place it on his left hand, please? Repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. For as much as the two of you have come together, Heath and Lauren, in front of God and these witnesses, it is my honor and my privilege as a minister of the gospel, as a certified pastor of the state of Georgia, to now pronounce you husband and wife. Do you want to kiss your bride?